Hi everyone, it's Charlene from Social Dressmaking and welcome to my October catch up. So, as I said, when did I load that video? Sunday? Whenever I uploaded my last fabric haul, I have been a bit MIA recently on YouTube. I just have not had the time to make any videos, and then to be honest, I wasn't really making a lot of stuff for myself, especially like August, September. It was just, I was so busy with alterations, with weddings and all that sort of thing. So yeah, it's been a while since I was really sewing for myself, and yeah, then it's just taken a wee while, probably readjusting to going back to school with the kids and yeah, just loads of things. We were away for a weekend too, me and Darren. We went over to England. He was over training to be a snooker coach, and I decided to tag along and went up to the rag shop and met up with my friend Jen Legg Teeth Creatives over on Instagram, if any of you follow her. So yeah, it was such a lovely weekend, really really nice. I've already shared some of the fabrics that I got in the rag shop when I was there in my last video, and I have a few more bits that I'm going to share with you today. So yeah, this is just sort of a catch up. There's a few things that I've made that I haven't spoke about already that I'm going to share with you, but yeah, not really a huge amount. First thing, which I actually made last night. So Emily was sick at the weekend, and it was a long 4 days when she was not well. Just that constant waiting for her to throw up again. It was awful. But anyway, last night then, I just felt like I needed something quick and easy and something for me, something I wanted to make for myself. So I pulled out this Lilac Mind the Maker Organic Sweat. I got the main fabric from Good Fabric for my birthday, and then the ribbing, I picked it up from Lamazi Fabrics because I was ordering some other fabrics from there as well. So yeah, it's the Jackson sweater again. I think I've nailed the fit now. I've nailed my perfect fit that I like in a sweatshirt, so loose and slouchy, and yeah, so I'm not going to change now. I'm just going to stick with that pattern, and I can make it so quickly as well. I don't know how long it took me to cut, but to make this one, it took 38 minutes according to Instagram. So yeah, it was pretty quick, and yeah, I love it with the ribbon. It just makes it so much easier and sits, the neckline and all sits so much flatter. But yeah, so happy I made this, and it's nice to have a brighter color to wear now, especially when the weather's I don't know what it is. It was miserable this morning, and now it's actually quite warm, and I just don't think it knows what to do. But this is nice and soft but not too heavy, which is perfect. So yeah, this is one of the things that I've made. There's a few other things that I'm working on. I'll grab one here. So this is the Mont Royal jacket by Atelier 8 Avril, and I'm making it in a Robert Kaufman Taos flannel, which is one of my last Minerva projects. So yeah, I've been working away on it. I've lost my other epaulette, so I need to find it before I can do the other sleeve, or else just recut it. But yeah, I'm really, really happy with how this is coming together. I love that statement shoulder, and yeah, the whole thing is just going to be so nice and cozy and perfect for layering up this season. So I've been working away on that, just dipping in and out of it, and I made a few things for the kids. So I made for Emily, I made two pairs of the classic scruffle leggings by the Sewn Edge. So this is just the plain version. We made them in a navy jersey from organic cotton jersey from the rag shop, and made them for her nursery and also just for wearing in general. It's so hard, she's so tall and skinny, it's hard to get leggings and things that actually fit her. So we made two pairs of them, and I have a wee top cut out as well in the jersey. And I've made her a mini Jara sweater, I'll put a wee picture in a brushed floral sweat from, again, it was from the rag shop, but it sold out. It was from start of the year, I think we had it in March, April sort of time. It was a remnant that it was actually some that Steph had left over from when she made her own jumper, and she sent it over for Emily. It was the perfect amount for a wee jumper for her. And then the other thing that I made was a Sonic the Hedgehog hoodie for Charlie. So he's been asking me for this for months. I think I've had it cut for 2 months, and I've probably had the fabric. I maybe got it 2 months before that, and then he has been asking for it for, I don't know, so long, so long. So I finally got it done. I have the tracks bottoms cut as well to match it, but he was just so happy he got the hoodie. So it's just a blue hoodie. I used the Constance sweater by So Little Seam. I've made that for him before, and just hacked the hood so it has like a panel down the middle and then the spikes coming out the side. So I'll put a few pictures in. He is just thrilled, so happy with that hoodie. So yeah, I got lots of extra mum brownie points up for making him that. And that's it really. There's a few other things that I've been making, but most of it I think I shared on my last video for the rag shop. Yeah, it's been hard squeezing in time to sew for myself in around everything else that I'm doing, which is brilliant. I'm so happy that I'm so busy, but yeah, at the moment I've so many autumn plans that I just really want to get stuck into them. So yeah, when I was away in England, I picked up a few wee bits, not a huge amount. The first place we went actually in York was Joanna Wakefield Jewellery. So Jen had messaged her and asked could we pop into the studio, and so she does some sewing themed jewellery. There's like wee teeny tiny studs that are buttons with like the colored thread in the middle, which are really cute. And there's a needle necklace, and there's wee vintage like sewing reels as well, and like earrings, necklaces and stuff. I picked up this wee bracelet here, so it's just a wee leather band with the silver hoop in the middle, and you probably won't be able to see them. I'll put a wee picture in. These earrings are the three stages of the moon, so crescent moon, half moon, and full moon, in silver, and I just love them. So then the other place that we went to was Socializing in York as well, which fabric shop, and I got these bits here. So I got some Liberty. So it's not the Tantalon, it is, I think it's either the poplin, I don't think it's the quilting cotton, I don't think it's that heavy. But yes, so I got this beautiful floral, which I just absolutely love. I love the colors, and you'll see with these other two fabrics as well, it is just fitting in so well with my color palette this season. I'm going for a lot of like rusts and browns and deep reds, like browny reds and that sort of color. So yeah, really happy with this, and I think that lighter like peachy floral is going to be perfect for like some springtime as well. It's not just going to be an autumn fabric. And I got 2.5 meters of it, and it is going to be the Anthea blouse. That's right, I have made an Anthea blouse too. But I haven't got pictures of it yet. So I made it in a Lady McElroy cotton lawn that I had in my stash. I was gonna cut it straight out in this, and then I thought, no, I'll just check and make sure that I do like it. And it's just as well because I didn't cut the back out on the fold, I cut the front on the fold, so I ended up having to put a seam down the back, which was fine in that one. It's a wee bit tight around the neck, because I've lost that 2 centimeters from like the back neckline, but apart from that, it's fine. But yes, so I am going to be making this. An Anthea blouse in this. Hopefully I will have, the way it's cut out, there is quite a lot sort of wasted, especially on the narrower width, so I'm hoping that I'll be able to cut out a collar as well, a detachable collar like I've done with my Anthea dress. And I'm probably gonna do like a similar to the Bakerloo collar, but I'm gonna do like a wee black ruffle around the edge. I think it's gonna be really nice, and then that'll be something I can pair with other things as well then, obviously too. So yeah, really excited about sewing this and cutting it out. I think this is the first Liberty fabric that I've actually bought for myself. I won some fat quarters from Alice Caroline. It's on an Instagram competition, and over here, nope, here we are. I won these Tantalon fat quarters on Instagram, and I'm thinking I'm probably gonna make a wee dress for Emily with them, because I think those like florals are all tying really, really nicely together. I love these two. I just think that star fabric there is just gorgeous. But yeah, as I say, I won these over on Instagram, so I'm probably going to make something for Emily out of them, a wee color blocked dress. So yeah, but yeah, this is the first Liberty that I've actually bought for myself, and I love it. Definitely want to get my hands on some of the Tanalon as well. It might go on my Christmas list, to see if somebody will get me it. And then the other things I got, so I'd spotted this grey ribbon, not very exciting, but I like to have like a stash of grey ribbon, just because it's one of those things that when I do get grey sweatshirt in, it's hard to sometimes find a ribbon that matches, and at least if I have a wee stash, I can use whatever I have. And I like that this is like the marled sort of effect. It's got like different tones in it, so it should go with plenty of different jerseys. And yeah, it's just handy to have, one of those basics to have in your stash. And the other thing which I have been wanting to get for ages is the Seams Couturiers hand cream. So yeah, it's the one that it absorbs really quickly and doesn't leave any greasy residue. So obviously with working with, especially with bridal wear and things like that, I can't really wear hand cream that much, and I've always wanted to get this to try it. I've never seen it there. I just thought, yeah, I'm gonna pick it up, and it's brilliant. Really, really nice. Smells lovely, and it definitely does absorb very quickly and does leave my hands really, really soft. So it's nice to have that wee treat as well. Then I've two, well, this is from Lumazi Fabrics, the ribbon, and I have another two fabrics from them. So I did the Autumn Trends roundup recently over on Lumazi Fabrics on their blog. So I got a voucher to spend for as payment for that. So this is what I got with that voucher. First is this Allure single knit jersey, I think it's called. It's kind of like, still a wee bit damp, I'm finding it so hard to get things dried at the moment. It's not quite a t-shirt, it's drapier than like a cotton jersey, kind of more like a viscose or bamboo jersey, but heavier, and it feels more like a knitted fabric, like a jumper, like a lightweight jumper, as opposed to a jersey. So incredibly soft. I think the top side has like a brushed sort of effect to it, and it's just, I mean, look at that, like drape. It is just, it's so nice. It's a beautiful fabric and quite reasonably priced. I think it's about £14 a meter, but for this fabric, I think that is very, very good. And yeah, I was back and forth with how much to get, and I just got a meter off it to make like a sort of loose t-shirt, but kind of want more now and some of the other colors. But yeah, it's beautiful. I think this color was pecan, the same as my floral fabric. I'm not sure, I can check, but yeah, absolutely gorgeous fabric, really, really lovely. And then this floral has been literally on my mind for like, I don't know, 6 months or something since I got it in. So this is the pecan floral viscose or rayon. I can't remember if it's viscose or rayon. But I love it. I really love it. I think what was putting me off was the brown background, and I don't really know why, because I love it. Like, I really, really do love it. And it has these gorgeous like teal and sort of like a blush flower in it as well. And I love those deep like greens and teals there, and then the lighter floral. I just think it's stunning. It's really, really lovely. And I do have a pair of boots that are going to match it perfectly. And I love that then with this, I can wear it with black or navy as well in terms of accessories. So I have 3 meters, and it's going to be a dress. Don't know what dress yet. Still trying to decide. But yeah, I love it so much. It kind of reminds me of the Lady McElroy Vincent sketch floral that was out maybe 2 years ago now. It had like all those browns and greens and like a peachy sort of colour floral as well in it. And yeah, it's one of my favourite fabrics ever. And I think that's maybe what kept drawing me to this one as well. So very excited to work on this one too. And as you can see, it is tying in. There's lots of these sort of colours coming through now this season for me. And then I have another fabric here I'm going to show you. It is from Crafty So and So, and it's for an upcoming blog post for them. It's quite an easy make, which is good because it's due next week. Well, show you it now anyway. So this is the Luna rayon, I think it's called. It's beautiful quality, really, really lovely. It is one of their sort of pricier rayons. I think it's about £20 a meter, maybe a wee bit more. And yeah, I just think it is stunning. Really love it. Matches my earrings quite well with the phases of the moon on it. Yeah. And I'll not tell you what I'm making, you can wait and see the blog post. But yeah, I just think it's stunning. It has a really, really nice soft feel to it. Not too sheer, and good for this time of the year. I think it's kind of like, again, abstract take on a polka dot. It's not quite, it's obviously not a polka dot, but it has that same sort of a feel to it, but just a wee bit different. So yeah, very excited to get this made. And yeah, then two other fabrics here to show you. So I just got these today, this morning. The Dab Hand, which is a online store based in Belfast. So, well, they're an online store. They started off doing pop-up shops in Belfast, which was amazing because obviously we don't have many fabric shops over here, especially when it comes to like dressmaking fabric shops as opposed to quilting or like formal or that sort of thing. So it really was lovely to have somewhere that you could go. It was usually once a month and you could go and you could actually feel the fabrics and meet up with people, and it was just so nice. And then they moved online as well, but just over the pandemic, different things happened and they made the decision then to close down. So they had a closing down sale on Friday. So I think this coating was down to like £4 a meter. It's a Prince of Wales check, so it is brushed on the back and then has the check on the front here. I've realized it's extremely similar to the other coat fabric I have at the moment, so I'm thinking now I'm going to make a blazer in this, and then I'll have some left over for something else too. I'll either de-stash it or I don't know, make something for like Darren, or I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, it is beautiful. It's really, really lovely, and I love this green and red stripe through it. The red actually matches perfectly with the tencel I had in my video the other day from the rag shop. It pairs perfectly with, so I think that blazer with then the red trousers is going to be so nice. And yeah, I have loads of green too, so it is, it's, I think the blazer, I have a blazer that was from H&M and I have worn it so much. It was a bargain, I think it was less than £10 anyway in the sale. And but it's just getting, I can wear it okay with like a t-shirt underneath, but I can't get anything heavier, like even a sweatshirt, it's just too much. So I'm gonna do like a more oversized sort of boyfriend kind of blazer, so that I can sort of replace that one in the winter months, because I love layering it with like jumpers and things like that. So that's what that is going to be. And then the other fabric I got, I think both of these are sold out. They did have loads of remnants on them. This one is a grey and like mustard windowpane check sitting. I think it is, it's a polyviscose sitting as far as I remember. Wee bit of stretch in it, happy days. And I had always had my eye on this fabric and never got it. And now that I've been making more trousers recently, and they are, I know which patterns to use for myself. So I got a meter and a half of this to either make the bisque trousers, or by Vivian, I can't remember her name. I'll link it down below, either the bisque trousers, or if I don't have enough for them, I'll be making another Perf Mod trousers because I just love them. So yeah, this is going to be trousers and I just love it. So yeah, very excited about these. I'm probably gonna try and get this straight into the pre-wash today because I'm just loving the trousers that I'm making at the moment. And yeah, that's everything. I am working on a pattern test at the moment. Well, I have pattern tests for me, and then there's kids pattern tests that I'm working on as well at the moment, so can't wait to share them. They should be out sometime in November, so hopefully I'll do another video soon to catch up with you all. And yeah, I'll not leave it so long the next time. I'm hoping now that, yeah, now that I'm back into the swing of it, I'll start sharing more. I have another pattern test actually that I've finished and all. I'm not sure when it's being released, but I'll be sharing that soon too. And yeah, that's really everything from me. Well, not everything, but condensed version of everything that has been happening. So I hope everyone is keeping well. If you'd like to buy me a coffee, I'll pop the link for my Ko-fi page down below. And yeah, I hope you're all having a lovely day and are getting loads of lovely autumnal things sewn up if you are in autumn or spring, if you're on the other side of the world. Let me know below what you are sewing or making at the moment. And yeah, I will catch up with you all soon.